What's up, guys? In today's episode, we've got some information about how to do a leak down test on a motor. Kevin goes on about it with his setup with his 900RR. Take a look, subscribe, give me some feedback. Thanks, guys.
So we'll do some learning that we did today. We pressure tested our motor, so I can quick go over pressure testing of a motor. Really simple. I just used a pop-off gauge that I already had, and I just drilled some holes in a plate of aluminum I had, and this is a speed plate, so there's O-rings underneath it sealing it there. And then from there, this is just a 3-inch plug cap for a plumbing drain. With a hose clamp on it, sealing off your exhaust. And then with your power valves installed, your head on, your cylinders on, your cases and everything together, this should seal up your motor. So from there, I mean, the pop-off gauge is definitely not the best option. It's just right now I don't have a pressure gauge set up, but it's also the easiest way for just Joe Schmo to do it as well. But you can just pump up your cylinder with your pop-up gauge. It takes a while. You just pump. And 8 PSI is like the max you'd want to go. I would just do like 5 PSI, mainly for the sake of this video, so somebody doesn't fuck something up on their motor. But right. But basically what we found today, you gotta have your spark plugs in obviously to seal it, and we just did the timing. So we found our power valves were leaking. So on my power valve gaskets, they were leaking and I couldn't get them to seal up. So I talked to Dusty and he gave me some good advice to just put a little bit of grease around it, just regular old bearing grease. So we took our power valves out, we put grease around both sides of the gaskets, put them back in, and our power valves sealed up. Unfortunately, today we found out our front crank seal is leaking. So later today we're gonna have to flip this motor over and put brand new crank seals in it, unfortunately. But it's better to find it now than run into issues in the future. And then the other thing, when I was down here and we were doing this, and I'll do a video on how to lap your crank to your flywheel, but we can do that later. But I was having issues with getting water in my flywheel cover, and I couldn't figure it out all last year, and I ate up a couple starters and stuff like that. And then we just kind of figured out today that on these MSTs, basically, I don't know if it's blinding or not, but there are three holes not being used on your delete or the plug-in for through your case. So pretty obvious, you know, leak to get water in your motor. So when you set up your flywheel cover and you're using an MSD setup, just make sure, I'm just gonna use RTV and plug all these three extra holes, and I'm actually gonna RTV around the wires themselves too. So just kind of a silly thing I found today that might be useful, like when you're already tearing everything apart and setting everything, just plug all those three holes so you don't get any water. Cause this is where all your electronics are, and the nose of your starter doesn't have any seals in it. So if you get water in here, you get water in your starter, and then everything's gonna just break and not a lot of fun. So just a few things to check out in the future there. So
that's all. One good thing, the way you're pressure testing it, is you're pressure testing with a intake manifold and the exhaust manifold on, so you're
all gaskets,
checking all the seals. And
that's another thing, like intake leaks are like extremely critical. So if you have any leaks after your carburetor, you're going to put your motor into a lean condition. So basically it's gonna be sucking extra air, which lean conditions are not good whatsoever. And they can cause runaway motors and all kinds of other stuff. So when you pressure test it, you know, making sure you pressure test it as much as you can before the carburetor, just to make sure you don't have any air leaks in that department, is a really big deal. So hopefully that'll save you guys some pain and misery in the future. So
Awesome.
Yeah, that's about it.
I was thinking about it, like, at first I was like mildly defensive of like Brad's advice, but I was like, well, actually, you know what? If we post videos of this, then we'll actually know what we're doing. We'll get a bunch of like other ideas and stuff. We just gotta stay open about it.
Yeah, I don't know if this works or not. It just ruins the magic eraser. People just step on it with dirty shoes.
Just F it.
Pressure washer?
I don't think that gets in there enough. I don't know if I did any good or not with this.
If you have any ideas on how to clean white turf, let me know. Hit me up.
Brian, your speed looks pretty darn good.
Oh yeah, the problem. If I was evidence, all I have to disclose it, I don't tell it.
Yeah, no, that's part of the problem, right?
That's okay.
$900R.
Yeah.
It's pretty sharp. Looks kind of new.
Fresh top end. Trying to struggle putting the old fittings back in. Then the big 900 stock stroke, DASA 48s, PHP intake, all the good stuff.
That's good.
Real men ride skis under 1,000 cc's.
All right, whatever.
In reality, anything over 1,000 cc is just overcompensating
for
lack of skill.
Mm-hmm. That's what I got. Lack of skill.
Keep dropping.
You got it?
Yeah. I just figured so someone didn't have to walk backwards.
Feel the burn. You guys been working out.
Yeah, it's just... just a little jet ski workout for the summer. Get used to hauling a minute out of the beach.
Yeah, which one is my favorite? Gosh, I don't know.
Well,
super deep.
You'd be a fool not to love that FS too. It's literally the world's best thing in the world.
It's pretty nice.
The unicorn.
It even almost tried to kill me one time.
And the thing,
where we need to flash a picture of my. I'll
I think
send
the
you a
funniest thing is these are just Kirk's beater skis. Like these are just the shitty ones he has.
Yep.
Fiberglass F or carbon FS2, without a doubt, the best ski ever made.
Oh, it's awesome. Love it.
Yeah.
Super DVX.
The
awesome
super
too.
DVX.
You want to latch that hood latch just so it's at least put it down so it's.
Well, then they got. You got these two turds up above these two beautiful gems down here.
I know. Times are tough. You gotta do what you can.
What's this?
Right. Just as a reminder, the 2021 TC Jet Pilot sortie is happening August 26th through the 29th. 2021. It's gone on big for years and years now, and it's just a fantastic event. It's a tent camping event at Hoxilla Park in Lake City, Minnesota. Come check it out. Ride some skis with us. Have fun. It is a great, great time.
Party hard.
That does it for this week's episode. Next week, Kevin's going to go over how to set up your MSD timing on a total loss ignition. Stay tuned.